Okay, so we want to talk about one more thing in this context, and again, you'll see I want to emphasize application problems throughout when we're talking about derivatives. The application of derivatives, the interpretation of derivatives is going to be very important. So I have this first one that I gave you guys a PDF of, which says it's about company takeovers. So here it's from your textbook. During the buyout attempt, and we have two companies, Company X and Company Y. So Company Y is buying Company X. The accountants of Company Y develop a formula that relate total assets. So hold on, I'm going to make some notes while we're reading. This A is total assets, right? In millions of dollars, millions of dollars, right? Company Y can expect from the acquisition of Company X, T years, so this is in years, from time of takeover. Okay, so we have an assets to a time, like the input is time, and then we get assets for this new company Y. Okay? So that's this function. We have a limit on the domain of the function. T is only good for 15 years, it looks like, 0 to 15. And the question just says, find and interpret A of 4 and A prime of 4. So first, let me find A of 4. So A of 4 is 4 to the 5/4 plus 1 over 3 times 4 plus 6. So let me get this decimal. 4 to the 5/4 power is 5.66 over, and this is 12 in the denominator, 0.472 I get. And that output, if I look back up, is in millions of dollars right there. So millions of dollars. Or if you want to turn this in, I mean, sometimes it's hard to tell what 0.42 million look like. There's 1 million, right? A 1 followed by 6 zeros. So 0.42 has the, instead of 1 million, we would be there. The decimal point's right there. So I have $472,000 that of total assets. I can expect from the acquisition. Okay, so now I want to find A prime of 4. A prime of 4. Now, the first thing we need to do is find a prime of x. So let me go back up. I want to get this function that I lost. I think I kind of remember what it is. T to the 5/4 plus 1 and 3t plus 6. So here's a of t to the 5/4 plus 1 over 3t plus 6. Okay, let me just check one more time. I don't want to do this with the wrong function, right? Check your work. T to the 5/4 plus 1, 3t plus 6. Beautiful. Okay, so now I have to use, in order to differentiate, I have to use the quotient rule, right? I have kind of x in two places, and there's no way to simplify or combine them, or this is a t. So let's say f of t is this t to the 5 fourths plus 1. And when I take the derivative of that, I get 5 fourths out front, t, and then 5 fourths minus 1 should be 1 fourth. And the one is derivative of this constant 1 is 0. And g of x is equal to 3t plus 6, and g prime of x is equal to 3. Okay? So now I want to go ahead and plug in to the quotient rule. So you guys are very familiar with the quotient rule at this point. We've done a few problems. So if you will pause the video and do the quotient rule real quick on this particular problem, because we found these two derivatives, that would be great. So do the quotient rule for me and then come back and watch the video, okay? Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and apply the quotient rule here. So the quotient rule that says a prime of t is equal to, right, g f prime minus f g prime over g squared. Okay, so I get 3t plus 6. There's my g times f prime, which is 5 fourths, t to the 1 fourth, and minus f, t to the 5 fourths, plus 1 times g prime, over g squared, 3t plus 6. Okay? Now, I really just am interested in the final quantitative output, so I want to plug 4 into this, which can be pretty gross, but I'll go ahead and do that. So a prime of 4, without simplifying, the simplifying will be even worse. So everywhere I have a 3, a t, I'm going to plug in 4 plus 6, 5 fourths times 4 to the 1 fourth power, minus t to the 5 fourths plus 1, 3, over 3 to the 4, or 3 times 4 plus 6. Okay, let's see. Let me plug in these little pieces. 3 times 4 plus 6. That gives me 18 times 5 fourths times 4 to the 1 fourth power. And I think I get for this first little piece 31.819. Okay, so without rounding, I'm going to subtract this next piece minus on my calculator. Oops, I forgot to put a T. Can you see this one? Let me do it in red. This should right here be a 4. I'm going to plug in a 4 there. Okay. Minus 4 to the power of 5 fourths. Plus 1, all times 3. So, let me do this. 1 second. So I got the total answer. I forgot I want to fill this in. So this is minus 19. It's back in blue. 19.9706. And as a final answer that I'll carry down here, I get this 11.8492. Now, the denominator should be this 12 plus 6, just 18. Right? And it should be that squared, right? Look back up with me. Do we get that okay? This denominator here should be squared. Look here. That should be squared right there. This should be squared right here. And this 18 should be squared right there. So 18 squared, 324. So I'll put that in right here. $324. Okay, so let me get. Eleven point 8492. Oops. Hear me hitting wrong buttons on my calculator. Hold on. 11.84924 divided by 324. And I get 0.03657. Okay. Now this is the value of the derivative. Remember, a prime f4 is this numerical value, and I want to think carefully about what this means. Okay? So the original function a of t gives you an idea of total assets that company Y acquires or expects t years after this acquisition, right? Okay, and we know that the derivative comes from this idea of slope, the idea of the change in y divided by the change in x. Okay, so this is the slope of the tangent line at this point 4, x equal to 4, and the output should have been that output that we got up above, right? Okay, so here we go. So this tells me that the change in y over the change in x is this 0.03657. But I'm kind of interested in what maybe these units are. So how the change in y is like a change in assets, right? Change in the monetary value of assets to a change in time. And in some ways, I don't really have a denominator. I can think of this as over 1, right? If I really want to interpret this. So for a 1 year change, I expect this increase in assets. Again, I want to go back to, because this is in millions of dollars, again, I want to translate this. There's my 1 million, right? There's a million. So the 0.03, so if I had a 1, it would be 1 million, right, as the output. So that's right here, and the decimal point then gets right there, and then that means my I have a 0, and there's my 36570. So really, it's this increase. I get a $36,570, and I'm going to say it's an increase because it's a positive number, right? Like the derivative is positive, I think that's going up. So I expect for the next year, from year 4 to 5, I expect an increase in total assets of $36,570 from this acquisition. So please go back. Like this idea, the idea of the derivative, links back surely to and securely to the idea of how output is changing when you change input values. And that's the value of it as an analytical tool. What happens when I just make this one change? Or, for example, here as a predictor, what should I expect to see in this acquisition change or the change in this, the total value of assets from this acquisition when I'm just letting a year pass by? Okay? So it kind of gives you an idea. And if you have modeled things correctly or accurately, it can give you kind of a predictor of long-term behavior. Okay, so I think there's one more problem, but I want to do that in a separate video to keep these short. So come back for that, but let me know if you have any questions.